All right. So, let's see here. Let's talk about Sakura. Let me preface this by saying that everything you're about to hear is my own opinion of someone who's been playing Sakura for quite some time now. And I'm not new to Street Fighter V. I've been playing this game since it came out, since beta. And I'm also experienced in other fighting games as well. And I kind of know what to look for in terms of character power, how tools match up to other characters' tools, and kind of how strengths are supposed to work versus weaknesses, and how to balance all that kind of stuff out. So with that being said, let me start with Sakura by saying that design-wise, I think her design is okay. It's not great, it's not perfect, but there are some questionable things that you kind of just ask yourself why, you know? Like, for example, very first thing when I started playing Sakura is, why does her light kick have more range than crouching medium kick? And you've seen me play months and months now where crouching medium kick literally just whiffs during combos, right? Or it doesn't connect all the way, where you'll see crouching medium kick not connect into EX Tatsu. It's not an input problem, it's literally just the character's max range combos don't work consistently. You've also seen back fierce, right? Back fierce is hard to hit sometimes. It's just a lot of her stuff is just inconsistent, right? Who knows if that's a problem with the character was rushed, or it was an oversight, who knows, right? But there's a lot of stuff about Sakura design-wise that just doesn't make sense. For example, here's a perfect example of what I mean by this, right? Even though you would think light kick is an amazing button with Sakura, and it is, it's good, right? But since it's a light button, it scales her combos a lot more, and it loses in the priority system. And a lot of characters' best buttons are medium and heavy buttons, correct? So if you're trying to play footsies with this button, more of the times you're gonna lose. You see a lot of people try to buffer this, but if your player's if your opponent is better than you, you're just gonna get counter hit and whiff punished all the time. This actually has 12 frames of recovery, by the way. And so that's why it sucks that this is her best button, because it loses in all those other aspects. You know, this button has no use. It literally just doesn't go anywhere. This has no range, makes her combos really hard to hit or hit confirm. And then you have to use light kick for everything, because it just scales the combo and it makes everything that much worse. Now, let's talk about her V skill. It's like a really, really slow ghetto version of Demon Flip. And it really is only useful for V-Trigger 2 combos. So if you're in V-Trigger 2, you get your little combo extension, right? You get the little dive kick afterwards and uppercut. That's literally it. That is the extent of her V skill. It literally has no other use other than that, right? You can charge fireball and cancel into it, but in retrospect, or in practice, it doesn't offer very much value. You see a lot of instances where Sakura is actually getting punished for trying to get a good read on a jump in, right? You see a lot of people try to jump over Sakura's fireballs when she's charging, and so you do the air one to catch them trying to jump over it. But a lot of instances, it'll whiff. Just another oversight of, well, this is kind of dissipating before I'm actually getting punished for having the correct read, right? It's just small stuff like that, small quality of life stuff that Sakura is suffering from. Now, to get into the meat and potatoes is why Sakura's not a good character in this game. It's because Sakura doesn't have what is good in this game. You can name a whole bunch of stuff that's good in this game, right? Having a three-frame button, having a reversal, having long-range buttons, or having crush counter buttons, having a robbery V trigger, having big damage, having a fireball. She has a lot of that stuff, but a lot of it is just really, really bad. You know what I mean? Akuma is a perfect example of a character that has all of those things I just mentioned, but he does all of that way better than Sakura does. Right. So why would you play Sakura over Akuma? Right? Why would I want to use this demon flip when I have a real demon flip that leads to a 5-6-way mix-up? You know what I mean? Now, don't get me wrong, Sakura is a good character, okay? She is a good character. But in relation to the rest of the cast and their tool sets, she becomes a bad character. you would think that having some of the best walk speed in the entire game, right? Her forward dash is ridiculous, right? Her walk speed is ridiculous. That stuff is good, right? That is something that is kind of that should be strong in a fighting game. But how come a character like that that has something like that is considered so weak? Is because this isn't what is strong in this particular fighting game, right? In what scenario is walking forward good in Street Fighter V? It's not. You're just going to get hit by everything because it's really hard to block in Street Fighter V because of the input delay and then the online delay, et cetera, et cetera, right? Full screen tackle EX moves from Urien and EX Zong from Cody or EX Bullhead from Birdie. You're just going to get clipped because you can't walk and block that crap. So having good walk speed, that don't matter. The only thing good walk speed is for the shimmy, right? That's about it. It all boils down to they didn't give anything to Sakura to make her stand out from other similar archetypes. That's literally what it comes down to. I'm not saying Sakura is terrible. I'm saying that she's terrible in relation to the rest of the cast. That's what makes her bad. She's not a bad character on her own. She just needs to not be... She needs to have something that makes her playable. You know what I mean? It's like... Sakura has good corner carry, Larry. Sakura has good corner carry. Every character in this game has good corner carry. That's an example of something that doesn't make her stand out. That's not an example of something that makes her... That makes somebody want to play her over another character that also has good carry. Like Rashid, Ken... Akuma. I could go on and on and on of all the characters that have amazing corner carry in this game, right? That's not something that makes her stand out. You know, having a fireball, that doesn't make her stand out. Having the worst Tatsus in the entire game, that doesn't make her stand out. What does Sakura have that makes her stand out? She has a worse version of Demon Flip. A lot of characters have something that's similar to this, but this is like one of the worst versions of it, right? Her buttons are really bad. Why would I ever play this character for her buttons? This is supposed to be a footsie character, right? Why would I play this character for her good buttons? Like, Manat has some of the best normals in the game and you can't whiff punish them. Why would I play Sakura in that regard? Why? This button has no range. This button is useless. This button is useless outside of combos. This button is useless. Sweep has no range. It's useless. She has like four useless buttons, right? Because it's all the power is locked in the light kick, which has three detriments attached to it. It's just a lot of really bad design decisions with Sakura. That's all. They didn't give her any... She's literally just... People wanted Sakura, so let's just give them Sakura. That's all they did with this character. They didn't really put any effort into her, in my opinion. And it sucks, because I think she's a really cool, fun character. Like, when I watch Chris G play Sakura in Street Fighter 4, I'm like, damn. When Street Fighter 5 comes out, I'm gonna play this character. I really want to play Sakura. And she didn't come out till Season 3, and then once Season 3 came around and she finally came out, we were left with a very subpar version of Sakura, you know? They didn't give her back Tatsu loops, her fireballs are garbage, her V-triggers are very lackluster. And real quick, a lot of people say Sakura does have a robbery V-trigger with her V-trigger 2. I disagree. Here's the biggest difference between a robbery V-trigger and a V-trigger like Sakura's, right? If I do sweep V-trigger with Sakura, what do I get off that? I get a throw. That's all I get. Assuming you don't tech it, right? A good player is never, ever, ever going to tech mid-screen. There's no reason to, especially against Sakura, who has huge damage output, right? So just take the throw. I get nothing off of that. I go back to neutral. As where if I'm Manat and I pop V-trigger, I'm in an infinite block stream 50-50 vortex that's all safe on block, right? If I pop V-trigger or Sakura, I still have to earn my hit. I can't just pop V-trigger and you're in an instant 50-50. I still got to earn everything that Sakura does with Sakura's V-trigger too. That's all. It's not really, it can't rob you. You're literally just getting outplayed by getting opened up. That's literally it. You know what I mean? Or Mika. When Mika pops V-trigger, that's a walking 50-50. If Geef pops V-trigger, that's another 50-50. Or how about... who's another good example? Anyways, you guys get the point. That's my opinion on Sakura. Now, to conclude, let me just say that I love this character. I'm going to continue playing her. I consider her my main character. And despite all her faults, I hope that Capcom will take whatever feedback that they're getting about this character and adjust accordingly. You know what I mean? I still play Cammy, don't get me wrong. I'm going to continue to play Cammy. But I don't want to play her as much. You know what I mean? Really, I'm only playing Cammy when I get super frustrated with Sakura. That's really it. Like, otherwise, I play Sakura nonstop. One person asked me, what would I change about Sakura? I think that's what people really want to know. So, here's the thing. If they buff Sakura too much, she's going to be broken. But again, it all falls back on how Capcom wants to balance the game. Do they just want to leave the mid tiers alone, leave them where they're at, nerf the top tiers, or buff the low tiers to match the top tiers? Because in reality, the top five characters in the game, Monat, Guile, Akuma, Ibuki, and Guile, are all just so much better than the rest of the mid tiers and the low tiers, right? So, I personally don't think they should touch the top tiers, right? I've never been a fan of nerfing characters that are strong, because all it does is ruin the character for people, and then they stop playing them, and then move on to the next top tier character. So leave the top tier characters alone. I'm not saying don't touch them at all. There are some absurd things that need to be toned down just a little bit, but don't overdo it, you know what I mean? Like, for example, Akuma's EX Demon Flip Slide. That should not be plus on block. That should be at least minus. That should be at least zero, or, you know, minus one or something like that. Just small stuff like that. What I think they should do is buff the low tiers to match. So Sakura, I would consider her low tier, low mid, like extra low mid. So she could use some quality of life changes. So this right here, this is the first buff I would give her. Immediate light kick, uppercut. That needs to have Oki, right? I get nothing off this mid-screen as Sakura. Nothing. Especially if you back roll, then I really get nothing. So they need to give her Oki off of that. This literally sends people full screen. And if I do the light one, then you're really going full screen. So get Oki off the, the reason why I want that buff is because that's where a majority of her hit confirms and damage come from. It seems weird that a character that struggles to get in doesn't get a reward for winning the neutral, right? So she needs to get some kind of reward for winning this neutral, especially when that's her biggest hit confirm right there. The next thing I would change is reduce the whiff recovery of Roundhouse. This button is so slow, and it's really her only button that has any sort of value in the neutral outside of light kick. And I get jumped in on a lot on whiff Roundhouse. You know, even if I try to space it perfectly, right, they're still jumping over me, and I eat 50% damage combo for trying to play neutral. So this button is just too slow. It needs to be a little faster. The next thing I would do is turn light DP into a fully invincible uppercut. Just for anti-airs, though, not like on wake up. This needs to be fully invincible to airborne attacks. It is absurd, and I've hated this since day one, that she's the only Shoto character, including Cammy, that cannot anti-air on reaction with an uppercut. That is absurd, right? This has no invincibility. If I try to uppercut with this, I'm going to get stuffed, and I'm going to eat a huge fat combo. A lot of her anti-airs are really inconsistent. They need to be a little better. So just cut all the BS and give her an anti-air that she deserves to have from the very beginning with Light Shoryu. This should be always an uppercut. I shouldn't be having to guess on jump-ins whenever Akuma jumps at me, right? I explained this yesterday, today, and the day before. If Akuma jumps at me, I have to guess every time. Because if he jumps Fireball and I do Crouch HP, that's a full combo. That's a full combo. If I guess that he's going to do jump Fireball and I try to walk under and he does, and I'm going to get a hit because I guessed wrong. So cut all the BS, and I shouldn't have to guess on jump ins. I should be able to do light uppercut and get rewarded for reacting. And lastly, I want her fireballs to remain bad. Only the ground fireball. Her ground fireball should be bad. They should not buff it. She's not supposed to have good fireball. She's not supposed to have good fireball character. She should be able to do grounded fireball from full screen, and that should be it. That's the tool to help her get in. I would buff her air fireballs, though. Her air fireballs do need a little bit of buff, because it's absurd that when you have the read on somebody and then the fireball dissipates, because the hitbox on her air fireballs, it's really tiny. So there are times when people are just jumping right into the fireball and it doesn't hit. Because it dissipates too slowly or the hitbox just misses completely. So I would buff the hitbox on her air fireballs. And that's literally it. Those are the only changes that I would make to Sakura. I mean, I don't know what they're going to do with her V skill because it's literally useless outside of V trigger 2 combos. In which case, if the new V system ends up being real, like they're adding a new V skill to every character, that'll be their opportunity to give her a good V skill, because this thing is just way too slow. It's way too slow. Even canceling into it, it's too slow. It's just way too slow. Whenever I play against a good player, they always anti-air me 100%, no matter if I'm doing crouch HP into it or whatever. It's just too slow. But yeah, those are the only changes that I would make to Sakura. Because like I said, she's on the thin line of being too good if they give her too much. And a lot of the stuff that I just talked about in terms of what I would change is quality of life stuff at best. You know what I mean? It's literally quality of life stuff that should have been there from the very beginning. Oh, and I forgot to mention more range on her and her medium buttons. Like, this button it's actually useless. So more range on her medium kick buttons. So that way her combos work and this button can actually be used as a poke as opposed to getting crush counter for throwing out stand light kick. But yeah, that's my Sakura rant, guys. I'll post this on YouTube. And yeah, now I can go look at the chat and answer questions. All right. In case you guys haven't noticed, when I rant, I never look at the chat because I can't think and talk at the same time, so I'm going through the chat now to see if you guys had any questions for me. If you guys had a question for me, usually it's really easier for me if you guys tag my name, so that way I can see it easy. Go DJ. Good games, DJ, man, if you're still in here. I actually did not mean to wake up Tatsu. I really didn't. I was trying to do wake up light kick into V-Trigger, I think. And what happened was my V-Trigger ran out, which is why that happened. So play Akuma. Yeah, that's a good point, Tesu. I don't know if you're serious or not, but yeah. Sakura, her crush counter combos kind of suck. Depending on the range, this is really all she gets. Dash up jab, right? And then I get no Oki off that. None. And since they nerfed the scaling on crush counter damage, my reward is even less. The only thing I can, if I get a crush counter, if I have V trigger, then I can do dash up crouching HP, which is max damage. But then I get a bunch of scaling because it was a crush counter and a V trigger activation. So there's extra scaling. But yeah, I wish she had a better crush counter combo. I think she should be able to get a dash up medium punch. I think that would be fair. That way I can link into back fierce or crouching medium kick and get heavy uppercut, which will lead to Oki. I don't think that's a necessary buff, but
I'm not getting out of this.
Like I
chair.
Said, if they buff the medium uppercut, then that wouldn't matter. Because then she would be able to get Oki. What's a robbery V trigger? G's V trigger one is pretty robbery. Who else has a robbery V trigger? Colleen's V-Trigger 2 is kind of nuts. Blanca probably has one of the best V-Triggers in the game with V-Trigger 2. His is pretty robbery. Balrog's V-Trigger is pretty robbery. Those are good examples of robbery V-Triggers. Things, V-Triggers that you don't have to put much effort in to open up your opponent or, you know, you don't get a 50, you get a 50-50 with. Abigail's V-trigger. Ultimate robbery V-trigger. I'm still scrolling through the chat, guys. I'm trying to catch up here. Actually, that's a good idea, man. Well, you didn't say the idea, but how do you guys feel about a day where we do song requests for subs? Would you guys be interested in that? That would be kind of a good incentive for you guys to sub. I should. The reason why I haven't done sub day in a long time is because I barely have any subs. You know what I mean? So if I build up a sub count, then I can start giving you guys some more cool stuff. Like, I wanted to give away an Aatrox, but I couldn't reach the sub count. I got some cool stuff to do for you guys, but I just need some subs. Why can't Sakura dash cancel charge fireballs? That would be kind of sick. So here's the rule, guys. If you guys didn't know this, canceling, like, let's say you want to cancel a fireball into V-Trigger like Akuma. You can only do that if it's 3 bars. That's the rule. If you have a 2-bar V-Trigger and you want to cancel on whiff into V-Trigger, you can't do it. Only if it's a 3-bar. That would be really strong. If she could cancel, charge fireball into V-Trigger, and then dash up and get some stuff going, that would be pretty good. But she doesn't have that luxury. But if I could, like, I don't know. Apparently they're adding V cancels in season 4, so who knows, maybe she'll get that. Akuma is the strongest Shoto, yeah. In my opinion, in order, Akuma is the best Shoto in the game, followed by Ken, then Sakura, then Ryu. I think Sakura is better than Ryu. Only by a little bit though. Because Ryu's got some huge damage, he has a parry, he actually has a useful Tatsu. Ryu's got some stuff going for him. I mean, look at this, guys. Look at this. Why would I... When would I ever use this jump Tatsu? Look how slow this is. It doesn't even cross up. But apparently in the files, it said that this was supposed to cross up. They took it away from her before that she launched. You know how good that would be if this crossed up? I could get over Guile or something like that, but this is useless. This is actually useless. So yeah, I just want them to buff the low tiers. I don't want them to nerf the top tiers. Here's a good example for Cammy. The only reasonable nerf that I would give to Cammy are two nerfs. Make it so that she can't anti-air with back strong. That should not be an anti-air for her. That is ridiculous. Right? It makes no sense that this is a character that can jump on you all day long, but you can't jump on her at all, right? She has like 9 anti-air buttons. She's got roundhouse, back fierce, light uppercut. Yeah. So they should take away her back strong anti-air. That is stupid. Also, they should make it so that her drills do different things. That would solve a lot of the problems that people are feeling frustrated by Cammy. So if Cammy wants Oki, then she has to do light drill because it would leave you closer to the opponent. If she wants corner carry, then do heavy drill, but you don't get Oki. You know what I mean? Then just, because as of right now, her heavy drill does everything. It gives her max corner carry, gives her full damage, and gives her Oki. It's just, it does everything for her. Jab, jab, heavy spiral arrow, you're in the corner already, and you get Oki, and you just got a bunch of damage. It's too much. So then, like, that would solve a lot of the pressure that she has. Like, Cammy's, it's brain dead pressure. So if you want a Cammy to think on offense, then now all of a sudden, do I want Oki? Do I want corner carry? Do I want a little bit extra damage? You know what I mean? That would make them think a little bit more about their offense with that one small change by separating her drills out. And that would be a reasonable, sensible change to the character. That would make her a little bit less frustrating to play against on defense. retro game says, thanks, I agree with everything. It's a huge problem of one of the characters shadow other care. Like Akuma. Yeah, Abigail. Yeah, you're absolutely right, man. There's characters that shadow other characters. And so that's a little, that's kind of what I talked about in my rant, is that they need to find something to give Sakura that makes her stand apart. And then do that with all the rest of the characters that are being shadowed, right? Abigail is in, or Gief is in Abigail's shadow, and Sakura and Ryu are in Akuma's shadow, and, you know. So give Zangief that makes him stand apart from Abigail. Give Sakura something that makes her stand apart from Akuma. Give them a tool that makes the person want to say, man, I need to play this character. She has this for this situation, you know? Otherwise, I just have a really worse version of Akuma's fireball. I have a really worse version of Akuma's Tatsu. I have a really worse version of Akuma's demon flip. I have no anti-air as Sakura. You know what I mean?